Domestic Airport, International Airport, Walleye Creek, Leesburg, Mania, East Hills, Molesworthy, Glenfield, Macquarie Fields, Ingleburn, Minto, Lumea, Campbelltown, and Macau.
Hello and welcome to STS Sydney Train Shots. I'm here at Circular Quay to film some trains and ferries for you all. So sit back, relax, and don't forget to subscribe. And yes, I did record this in a voiceover because that Tangara is really loud.
Okay, so the next train is about in 4 minutes, or departs in 4 minutes, so I might film some ferries.
The 11:45 train to Rigsby via airport stations on platform 2 is delayed by approximately 3 minutes.
The Clontarf, which is an Emerald Class ferry on wharf, I think that might be 6. Yes, wharf 6.
Maybe not actually.
No, it's wharf 3. The Clontarf will be running the F1 route to Manly. I'll see if we can catch a freshwater class ferry, as this is Sunday, so the larger freshwater vessels are hopefully out in the back. The Fishburn pulling in to wharf 4A, I think. B5 making up a Rigsby service.
The train on platform 2 goes to Rigsby via airport stations.
an A set approaching platform 1, performing a service to Leppington. It is A 60, if I am correct. Yes, A60. Also another A set approaching platform 2. A37. As you just heard, there's a few delays on platform 2. As I said, yeah, a few delays on platform 2. I'm not quite sure why that is. Other than that, there might be just a slightly slow train or a few other minor problems. Four minutes till the next train. The small river class ferry on Wharf 4, the Ruby Langford, is one of the newer river class ferries. I hope to do a video on them soon. They were plagued with a few problems, like they're supposed to run the Parramatta River run, but they couldn't fit under some certain bridges. B17 running towards Central, bound for Homebush. And another B set bound. Wow, that child's gonna be in a choir someday. Another B set bound for Lidcombe on the T3. The set is B32.
The train on platform 2 goes to Lidcombe. Next stop, St. James Museum Central. Goulston Park, Canterbury, Campsie, Melbourne, Lakemba, Wiley Park, Sunshine, Vanstas, Yuluna, Biron, Regent's Park, Barawa, and Lincoln.
Which makes for a bit more exciting footage. Set performing a service to MacArthur via airport stations approaching platform 2. A10. Interestingly, Circular Quay was the very first station to trial the platform gap fillers. I'll talk more about those in a sec after this train departs. Anyway, as I was saying about the platform gap fillers, they were very first, they were trialed here, and they look a little like this. Those little bits there, rubber sections, reduced the chance of people falling in the gap. And if you want to see how these were installed here, I recommend watching Inside Central Station, Australia's busiest railway station, on SBS, on demand. It's really good, and in one of the episodes, I can't remember which one, there's a lot, about 11, in one of the episodes it shows these being installed. The show was filmed in early 2020, and this was the first case of these platform gap fillers being used. Set approaching platform 2, bound for Revesby via airport. I'll tell you what set number it is in a second. It is B14. International Airport, Walleye Creek, Tumela, and then all stations to Greensby. trainee driver driving this train. Doors closing announcements sounded three times. But yeah, a trainee driver, and they're doing a very good job. They pulled into the platform perfectly. Interesting little bump in the welded track down there that makes for some nice interesting sounds when the trains depart. Next train should be a train on platform 1, goes to Leppington, departs in about 4 minutes, so it should be here pretty soon. I've always really loved the style of Circular Quay. Aside from the Carhill Expressway on top, nobody really likes that. But the columns, like that one there that hold up the expressway, I think are in a really nice design. Let me know what you think about it. I feel like I should go back and film some more ferries, but I know that the second I go and start filming the ferries, the train will arrive.
The 12:06 train to Liverpool via Bankstown on platform 2 is delayed by approximately 3 minutes.
Delayed trains on platform 2 also means we get to hear the nice custom announcements. Maybe I'll cut all this out, maybe I won't. Here it comes. It's a B set, going incredibly slowly. It must have some kind of speed restriction going through the city sample, aside from the regularly low speed limit on the city sample. It is B26.
The next train to arrive on platform 2 goes to Liverpool.
Another B set forming a Liverpool service. It is B3.
Central, Green Square, Mascot, Domestic Airport,
Italy. I am going to go to either domestic or international and film a video there, because I've always quite liked the station layout and design of Airport Link. There's a hopefully Revesby via airport in, I think it's about 6 minutes. The train on platform 2 is a MacArthur service via airport.
The train on platform 2 goes to MacArthur via airport stations. First stop, St. James Museum, Central, Green Square, Mascot, Domestic Airport, International Airport.
B31. The Bungaree and the Fairlight down there. The Bungaree is the one on the right. The Bungaree is a first generation Emerald class ferry, and the Fairlight is a second generation Emerald class ferry. The Bungaree is running the Watson's Bay route, and the Fairlight is running the Manly route. There's the Celebrity Eclipse at the cruise ship dock there, even though, to be perfectly honest, I don't care much for it. And the Supply Victor Chang and Charlotte down there. The Supply is on the right, the Victor Chang in the middle, and the Charlotte on the left. An A set bound for Redfern on platform 1. B set arriving on platform 2, and a few ferries departing. This B set is a Revesby via airport train. I'll board this train and then go film a vlog at Domestic or International. It is B24.
Closing, please stand clear.
Probably should have sat upstairs.